Foster. The coronavirus spread has California Governor Gavin Newsom issuing a stay-at-home order for everyone in the state except for necessities like food shopping and medical needs or for work deemed essential. Acting Homeland Security Secretary Chad Wolf tells Fox.
As of right now, we have no immediate plans to restrict domestic travel, although the president, the vice president, very clear on this, encouraging individuals to stay home.
Some senators, meantime, are facing questions about insider trading.
Republican Senators Richard Burr, Kelly Loeffler, and James Inhofe and Democrat Dianne Feinstein sold off stocks worth millions of dollars after classified briefings on the virus and before Wall Street took a massive hit. In a tweet, Loeffler called the accusations baseless, saying she does not make decisions about her own portfolio and learned of the transactions 3 weeks after they were made.
That's Fox's Rachel Sutherland. America's listening to Fox News.
Battery power made by Steel. From trimmers and mowers to chainsaws and blowers, Steel battery tools are exactly what you need to tackle your to-do list. Whether you need to maintain your yard or completely transform your landscape, battery power made by Steel. Steel is not sold at Lowe's or the Home Depot, always at a local Steel dealer. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. Lowe's and the Home Depot are trademarks of their respective companies.
I was in the hospital with my son for 18 months.
When he got injured, I knew I had to be strong.
I just remember rushing into his room and giving him a big hug and letting him know I was there.
These veterans and families are just a few of the heroes we serve at Homes for Our Troops. We build specially adapted custom homes with features like wheelchair access and automatic door openers that allow them to focus on their recovery and family.
This house is freedom.
It's hope. It's a new beginning.
Visit HFOTUSA.org.
Experience Keeneland like never before. Railbird returns August 22nd and 23rd in Lexington, Kentucky. See Jason Isbell in the 400 unit. Maren Morris, The Head and the Heart, Young the Giant, and over 30 acts across three stages. Plus live off-track betting, curated bourbon, equine culture, and more. Tickets are on sale now at RailbirdFest.com. Railbird, August 22nd and 23rd in Lexington, Kentucky. Get in the action at RailbirdFest.com.
Hey folks, this is Kurt Scott, minister at Caneyville Christian Church. I would like to invite you to worship with us Sundays at 11 a.m. and 6 p.m. Sunday school begins at 10 a.m. Hope to see you soon.
Cold Cock Jets face another hurdle. This is Roger Patterson with a minute of Vision for Life. Headlines like this one rolled off the presses the day after a Jets backup linebacker broke the jaw of their starting quarterback, Geno Smith. When Smith was sucker punched in training camp, the consequences were immediate. For Smith, his jaw was broken in two places. He endured a surgery and had to sit out nearly 10 weeks. For Incompale, he was immediately released from the team, potentially ending his time in the National Football League. For Jets fans, the consequences of another setback led SI's Peter King to say, "It's always something with the Jets." Like organizations whose cultures suffer repeatedly, families and individuals are often plagued with setback and scandal. A proverb rings true that we would heed well. Proverbs 27:17 states, "The prudent sees danger and hides himself, but the simple go on and suffer for it."
You've been listening to Dr. Roger Patterson with A Minute of Vision, a ministry of Vision for Life Radio at visionforlife.org.
Fox Sports Trending now.
News from the NBA, where the league announced it is shutting down all team training facilities to staff and players starting today to curb further spread of the coronavirus. Meanwhile, more players have tested positive, including Marcus Smart of the Boston Celtics and two yet-to-be-named players with the Los Angeles Lakers. News from the NFL, where Super Bowl-winning coach Sean Payton of the New Orleans Saints announced he has tested positive for the coronavirus. He is the first known coach or player from the NFL to test positive. Just 2 years after making him the highest-paid running back in league history, the LA Rams released Todd Gurley in a salary cap move. The 2017 NFL Offensive Player of the Year had 2 years remaining on his contract. He was about to get paid $10.5 million in a roster bonus. The Rams also let veteran linebacker Clay Matthews go. And in baseball news, the Boston Red Sox announced its star pitcher Chris Sale left Tommy John surgery on his left elbow. He missed the entire upcoming season. I'm Eddie Garcia.
We are Fox Sports!
K105 weather is brought to you by the three Grayson County locations of the Sicilian Bank.
Twin Lakes weather.
Breezy as we continue through the day and see a mix of sun and clouds this afternoon.
cold front brings some more scattered showers into the forecast. Could even see a few thunderstorms. But really what it's going to do is drive your temperatures into the 50s by this evening and into the 20s overnight. From the Wave 3 News Storm Tracking Team, I'm meteorologist Tawana Andrew.
When you find yourself alone, your demons come to light, and your mind is not your own. Lonely is the night when there's no one left to call. You feel the time is right, say the writing's on the wall.
This is In the Know for Friday, March 20, the 80th day of 2020. There are 286 days left in the year. Good morning, MB. Guiding you through In the Know at K105. On Litchfield's Country Station, 103.9 The Moose, live online at K105.com via the Apple and Android smartphone app using the SoundCloud or iTunes podcast. On Facebook Watch, on YouTube Live, on Periscope, and the hashtag is In the Know. Coming up today, we will update you on the latest news headlines from around the community, the county, the Commonwealth, and the country. What do you need to know? The very latest on the pandemic. We've got that. Got some fun stuff, too, and a whole lot more coming up today here on In the Know. Settling in to my left, rolling Mach 9 with her hair on fire, is my beautiful wife, the beautiful girl, it's Beach. Good morning, sweetheart.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm okay.
I think you know this, but I think there's an outside chance you don't know this,
okay,
that you introduced me as a person to the avocado. Did you know that?
I guess I'd never considered.
I was never really a fan of the avocado by itself until I met you.
It's good stuff.
It is good stuff. And so I thank you for that, because avocados help to lift mind fogginess. People who eat avocados improve their ability to focus, according to new research. The study found that people who ate an avocado each day were better at avoiding distractions. Can you buy that?
Yeah.
Yeah. And now,
do you remember that one time at the mountains that I tried avocados and eggs?
Yes.
It was an epic fail.
It was an epic fail. It really turned them a weird kind of color, yeah. But avocados are good. And now you won't be able to find them because I talked about how positive they are. Luckily, I already procured mine. She's the pride of Pumpkin Center, the heiress to the great Mini Burger Fortune. She's Vera Wang's arch nemesis and the professional bargain hunter's woman of the year, Misty Embry Thomas. Hey,
hey, here we go.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Big Bang Theory.
Big Bang Theory.
Pentecostal.
Pentecostal.
Fire and brimstone.
Fire and brimstone.
Mission Temple Flowers Stand.
How's Misty?
Healthy. it's where
negative.
We're at today.
It's rain. Negative.
My temperature's good.
Yep.
98.6 is that
good.
What's supposed to be.
Yep. Happy Friday to you.
Happy Friday.
A lot of people not sure how they're going to church this weekend.
We're about to go to
so
church.
So here
again.
You go. Let's
go.
Church a little more.
Let's
right
church.
Here.
It's tambourine, people.
Extra tambourine.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Big Bang Theory.
Big Bang Theory.
Pentecostal.
Pentecostal.
Fire and brimstone.
Fire and brimstone.
Can you make it safe?
Yeah. I don't know if you've heard the news, but UK won last night.
You know, I heard that.
UK beat the Cards last night.
Yeah.
Super excited about it, so I'm rocking my UK blue today.
Very good.
Trying to get back to what sometimes seems like a normal Friday. I don't know when we might be able to get back to a normal Friday, but I guess normal is what you make it.
Yeah,
right?
Our normal is still, like, we really haven't been abnormal at our house yet. So
Yet.
Hang on. Well, you know, with school over the last 2 years, I had turned into an introvert.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not been so foreign for me because I haven't been, you know, out and about amongst the peoples for a while.
I continue. So the biggest frustration for me
this entire week, and even going back into last week, was what I spent some time on yesterday. The little adage that I've created about too many people have too much access to too much information. Yeah. And I was reading a thing this morning and reminding people that organizations ranging from Facebook and Google to UNICEF are working hard to combat a flood of misleading and inaccurate stories about the coronavirus. Be skeptical of social media posts about the COVID-19 virus, even though they may even look like real news articles. I would encourage you to get out of your social media stream and go to K105.com, go to credible news organizations' websites, even straight to their pages, because it is not, actually truly not very difficult to make a piece of information look like it's coming from a credible source, and there are too many sheeple in the world who just look at it and go, they read the headline and no more, and now their opinion is formed, or they... or fear is escalated. And so we had more of that even yesterday. And that is the most frustrating thing of the whole thing. I've said from the very beginning, it's the panic. It's the fear that is the real bad thing about all this. The don't get used to, by the way, happy spring. I've not seen you since spring sprung at 10:49 last night.
Turned my air conditioner on for the first time yesterday.
You did?
Had to turn it off last night.
Oh, you did turn it off last night. It didn't get all that cool, but you would probably need to by tonight. Because we'll continue to be breezy, and it'll warm up a little bit through lunchtime, and then a front will move through, and the temperature's going to drop a good 20 degrees between now and this evening, and we'll get down into the 30s, the low 30s tonight. We'll have clouds early tonight. 33 is the low. Tomorrow is going to be one of those good stay-inside days because it's going to be a high of 49, mainly sunny, but the temperature won't break 50 tomorrow. So not a great first weekend of spring.
Well, since we're not allowed together.
That's right.
Or go outside. I guess it's a good thing that the weather's going to want to make us stay inside, just watch TV, take a nap, rest, spend some time with your family. I mean, technically it is the Old Testament Sabbath. Rest, hang out with Jesus.
That's right. You can do it. Governor Beshear gave his briefing yesterday afternoon and talked about 47 positive cases. A six-year-old has tested positive. A 64-year-old male with underlying conditions is the second death reported. And that's, you know, what we've been saying from the beginning, the most vulnerable, the people that you will see, the mortality rate will be of the upper demographic. And a lot of times there are underlying health issues that this maybe is just the thing, this was just too much to overcome. But I saw something shared last night, and again, I'm kind of have to hold, trying to take my own advice. Just because I see it doesn't mean it's true, but I did see someone trying to make a comparison case yesterday between Kentucky and Tennessee. And over the same timeline, you see Tennessee's rates of reported infection much higher in the 150, you know, in the higher than the 150 range, and showing Kentucky over the same timeline doing a much better job of flattening the curve. And if that information is correct, the optics of that look good. When you see it on a graph and you go, Tennessee's going and Kentucky is sort of going this way, then it's like, that's the trend, right? You want to see a hump in the road. Over a course of time, you want to see a speed bump in Kentucky. You don't want to see
An incline.
A jagged mountain, suddenly an Alp come up out of the road is what you don't want to see. Governor Beshear did dismiss rumors about a state forced lockdown and urged Kentuckians to depend only on proven and good sources of news. we're over here.
We good.
I don't care who your cousin's brother, sister's nephew works for.
Yeah, no. Unless you've got a sound bite and their badge in your hand.
I'm going to tell you.
I don't care.
I'd like to remind you again. If they were coming, you wouldn't know it, right?
Yeah.
I promise you. Yeah. You if they were, you wouldn't know it. So that means they're not.
They're going to sneak up on you like Joe Biden.
The governor had already recommended all mass public gatherings in, but today the state's public health commissioner, Dr. Stephen Stack, and acting secretary of the cabinet for health and family services, Eric Friedlander, issued a formal letter banning all mass gatherings. So
mass would be 10 or more, right?
Well, yes, but you know, here's one of the things I heard them stop using the word. I heard them stop using 10 or more.
Okay.
Yesterday, just as a, because what they feel like that's doing is they think, well, if it's 12, it's all right, or, well, we're close to 10, or it's, and so now they're just trying to say social distancing, try to eliminate being around people as much as possible. And then they even drug out a member of the clergy yesterday to try and help shape the thinking of church leadership as we head into the weekend. And we'll talk about that more in just a couple of minutes. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell has given us more information on, it may be information we already knew, but it's been, or thought, but it's been confirmed that $1,200 payments, a $1 trillion rescue is starting to take shape. It'd be $1,200 per person or $2,400 for couples. You would get $500 per child that you would have as a dependent.
Oh, I need my kids to come home.
I don't think they can suddenly get back in. I don't think they're standing out in your street saying, how many kids are in there? Otherwise, you'd be taking in neighborhood kids.
Well, I do have a couple. And some cats.
And so the caps are this, by the way. Those, that aid would be phased out at income thresholds of $75,000 per individual and $150,000 per couple. Now, I don't know. It says phased out. I don't think it's a pass-fail. I don't think if you're at that $75,000 number that it's nothing. I just think that it won't be the full $1,200. But we'll be knowing more about that. And then he also is claiming a $300 billion in loans to small businesses, including loans that would eventually be forgiven for employers who use them to meet payroll expenses. So if you have to have it to make payroll, then there could be forgiveness on those loans going forward.
Actually, my children benefit just being adults. Broke adults. Broke college adults.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
They don't make $75,000 a year, so they're worth more than the $500 on their own.
That's right. Grayson County Schools breakfast lunch program served over 3,000 meals in 2 days. It is proven that it is a service that is welcomed and needed.
Mm-hmm.
We also know that now, beginning this afternoon, I'll tell you, I brushed up against it late over the weekend, I think, when I saw the distribution list.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, if you go south of Litchfield on 259, there's not a distribution point all the way to the county line.
Yeah.
There's not one in Meredith. There was not one at Aneta. There was not one down near the lake. And I kind of wondered why. I was like, why not? And they have established one now at the Aneta Firehouse, and it'll be there this afternoon. So if you're in that part of the county and you want them to continue to distribute meals there, use the service.
Mm-hmm.
There's a reason that they hadn't. And then now there's a reason that they've added it. So if it's convenient for you, use it, because they're making decisions based upon where the need is.
Mm-hmm.
So show that there's a need, and they'll continue.
Yeah. So much.
They will continue to serve.
And they're not there very long. So
that's
it's from 1:15 to 1:30. So be there early, waiting for them, but use the service.
There's a playground there.
Yeah.
Social distance, though.
For the kids.
Oh.
Two swings apart.
One monkey on the monkey bars per permit.
Yes.
That's the way that it works.
And wipe down the monkey bars.
We're having to get innovative. And in ways now, we're going old school.
Mm-hmm.
Drive-ins may make a comeback. In particular, drive-in church. Wilson Creek Missionary Baptist Church in Carter County. So in Grayson, Kentucky, which is Carter County, over on the other end of the state, we'll have a drive-in service Sunday at 1 o'clock. For those who come, will stay in their cars and listen to the service while observing social distancing. I know I've heard of drive-through church or drive-in mm-hmm. churches around the country. Not a lot of them, but they're sort of novelties. And you think, well, that's kind of a neat thing to do. I think Panama City has one.
I've never heard of that. Does the pastor come out and stand on the roof?
Yeah. Yeah, he stands up at the, like, by the screen, maybe on top of a car or a van.
Yeah.
And then they pipe the audio into,
like,
just like you're going to the drive-in movies. And so you may see Olive Baptist Church in Hardin County is doing the same thing. And by the way, we have a small FM transmitter available for rent.
we got you covered.
I don't mean the one that we're using now. I mean, we do have a portable one that can be used. So you're seeing congregation have to get creative. Mm. I will tell you that I was very adamant this time last week about church service. Mm. And I will tell you that I have softened I don't know if it's my will or my resolve is being tested. I don't think that's what it is. But here's what. Last week, we didn't know near as much. We've absorbed the kind of the shock is over. Some of the defiance is starting to wane a little bit, at least for me. And here's what I will tell you. I know my paths that I have taken this week, and I don't come into contact direct. I come into virtual contact with a lot of people, but direct physical contact, not a lot. But that doesn't mean I haven't been around someone this week who has traveled, and it doesn't mean I haven't covered the same routes that other people have that could potentially be infected. And here's what I don't want. Here's what I would never want to think, that I carried something to my church congregation that made it difficult for someone who was vulnerable. Because last Sunday morning, there are those people that rely upon that close personal communication and hugs, and that was kind of business as normal some last Sunday, and that concerned me. Because I think you have to make the best decision for yourself. And I think that there are a lot of people looking at church leadership and they're modeling that behavior. And if church leadership says, we're having church, then people start to think, well, it's not all that serious then. And now I can go to the store. I can go do whatever. Mm-hmm. And I just think that there are ways. Church is not being canceled. Church would be being relocated in its method of delivery. And let's not forget, we are the church.
We are the church.
Right? We are the church. Mm-hmm. The building's not, there is a church building, mm-hmm. but we are the church. And so if we come together, even virtually, mm-hmm. to worship the Lord, mm-hmm. and it doesn't have to be. I think, you know, Misty, I think Pastor Wayne said something very, it's not a 10 o'clock, church is not a 10 o'clock appointment.
Right.
You know, church can be at 9, it can mm-hmm. be at 11, it can be whatever. And I even heard Governor Beshear say yesterday, he pointed mm-hmm. at people, at operations like ours. We have, so Sunday morning on 103.9 The Moose, we have for you three different homecoming radio programs. We have for you a Potter's Hope service. We have for you a Clearview Baptist service. And so if you just tune in to maybe leaving something out, I don't know, but that you will have a way to plug in, mm-hmm. even if you are shut in on Sunday morning. And I know Southeast Christian has services, and not only on Sunday morning. You can get some of those on Sunday mm-hmm. night. They're coming to your television. They're coming to your radio. And so I think you just need to be responsible for your health, but maybe more importantly, the health of others.
Yeah, and there is a great divide among Christians right now about they're not going to shut down my church, and I'm not going to be led by a spirit of fear. But for me, I did not go last week because I wanted to practice social distancing, and that does not make me a second class Christian because I choose to not go to church on a Sunday when I know that there is a virus. Here's where I got to. Do we ever cancel church to protect people? And the answer is yes. When there is ice on the road or there are storms, church is canceled to protect people. So don't tell me that you have faith that God's going to protect you from the coronavirus when you don't have the faith to walk on the black ice to get in the parking lot. It's the same concept. This is a black ice you cannot see. It mm-hmm. is a predator, an invisible predator, and it could make people sick. And I got back to Exodus 12:13 when the death angel went over. God said two things: get under the blood and get in your house and be still until it's gone. And I said, okay, I am under the blood. I am a saved, spirit-filled Christian. I'm under the blood, and please do not treat me like a second-class Christian because I didn't get to the building on Sunday. But I promise you, we are fasting, we are praying. We saw a young lady come to Jesus yesterday at Potter's Hope because she was there to get free diapers. The church is still in action. Mm-hmm. So if you want to have community prayer, get on your phone and pray together because my intercessors are.
Yeah, there are multiple ways.
There's a lot of ways. If you want to tap in and ring the bells of heaven, there are ways to do that. And you don't have to be in the building touching each other.
Yeah, there are definitely ways for you to gather if you choose to do that. They may be unconventional, but it doesn't prevent you from doing so. Mm-hmm. So this is the time of week where a lot of those tough decisions are starting to take place or have taken place. And so people kind of need reassurance on on what to do. Funeral homes are also vulnerable in this time.
This is
of
so hard.
What to do, because now Kentucky funeral homes are staying open, but the way they're doing business must change, according to the Funeral Directors Association of Kentucky. Of course, with the ban on groups of 10 or more, then you're having to make changes on viewings, funerals, you know, a lack of visitation, et cetera. And so I guess different funeral homes are handling it different ways, but it is definitely a challenge in the challenging times that we are. Looks like the lawmakers are going to adjust their schedule amid the coronavirus outbreak. They will take a 2-week long break in response, and then looks like we'll reconvene maybe March 26th is what they're no, that can't be right. Because this is the
It said March 26th in the news story.
That's
but then
not a 2-week break.
Referenced April 1st as well. So I think there is a mistype on that date. I read that this morning.
And then the state budget. The Senate passed their version of the state budget yesterday. I think budget is overstating it at this point. Captain Jack Sparrow would say they're more like guidelines, really.
I need something in black and white to put my John Hancock
on. You may draw something
on.
Up and call it a budget.
Nobody's going to be able to follow that.
But it's going to be very difficult. The expenditure side, that probably is pretty easy. Mm-hmm. But let's not forget the difference between Kentucky and the federal government. Kentucky doesn't have a treasury. Right? When Kentucky runs out of money, they can't just print more like the federal government does.
Yeah.
And I also want to, I'm super excited that the Cats won last night.
It was such a great game. Who knew?
A great game. I was nervous. I mean, I just didn't know how it was going to go.
Yeah.
But the UK Classic Series continues tomorrow. Countdown is at 1 o'clock. UK versus Ohio State from 2011. Wonder how that one turns out. We got to get to a break. We'll come back. Got plenty more on the way here on In the Know.
Today, successful small businesses are lean, portable, and focused. If you're running your own business, you need to stay in tune to your customers, vendors, and employees. That doesn't leave much time for processing payroll and reporting, much less the overall performance of your business. The firm of Buckles, Travis, and Hart has a full offering of services for small businesses. Payroll processing, tax liability, unemployment, and financial reporting, just to name a few. Think of them like a built-in business manager, but they don't get sick and they don't ask for time off. Call or contact today to help get your business focused across the board. Buckles, Travis, and Hart, 270-259-5604. GraysonCPAs.com.
Our family caring for yours. Those five words speak volumes about what you can expect at Twin Lakes Regional Medical Center. Compare your hometown hospital to virtually any across the state, and you will find we offer world-class technologies and comprehensive healthcare solutions far exceeding your expectations. But equally important to what we can do is how we do it. The hometown touch, the personal care. Set us apart and leave you on the road to recovery and restoration with a new sense of trust and confidence. Twin Lakes Regional Medical Center.
Get lured in by a tender Filet-O-Fish from McDonald's. Enjoy two of them now for just $5. Made with flaky Alaskan pollock from sustainable fisheries, it's a crispy, steamy, tangy treat that'll leave you ready to dive in for another bite. Plus, add any size soft drink like an ice cold Sprite for just $1. Catch this deal before it's gone. Only at McDonald's. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with combo meal. Single item at regular price.
Uber says that ride volume's gone down by as much as 60 to 70% in recent days in the hardest hit cities like Seattle, and that by the end of the year, rides across the board will be down by 80%. CEO Dara Khosrowshahi says they're considering leveraging their network for delivering other things like medicine and basic goods. If you're looking to stream some shows and movies for free during the health crisis, there are some alternatives to Netflix. Sony's Crackle is an ad-supported streaming service, one that offers both movies and shows. Newcomer Free Drive is part of IMDb, the Internet Movie Database, and offers some content as well. And if you have a library card, you might check to see if your library has partnered with Hoopla. The digital media service allows you to check all sorts of stuff out. Nextdoor is launching a new interactive map to let neighbors offer to help one another during the outbreak. Called Help Map, the tool lets you mark yourself as available to help with anything from grocery shopping to childcare on the social network for neighbors. Tech Report, Larry Olson.
Oh, once I can see, this is mine, you can't take it. Long as I know I have love, I can
Today is Extraterrestrial Abduction Day.
Is that an option? Set aside
to celebrate all those times you were abducted by extraterrestrials. Elliot. Just more close encounters.
Same in my brain.
It's more close encounters of the third kind than ET.
Yeah, no, it's like, I want mashed potatoes now.
It's World Storytelling Day today. It's also Won't You Be My Neighbor Day today.
Yeah, at a distance. Gonna love you over there.
Love you at socially distanced.
Love you long
it's
time.
It's because it's the anniversary of Mr. Rogers' birth.
Oh.
So we'll talk more about that in the Gone But Not Forgotten section of today's program. Tomorrow is Common Courtesy Day.
Don't buy all the toilet paper.
Why do we have to have a day for that?
Maple syrup day is tomorrow. Sunday is As Young As You Feel Day.
Oh, dear.
And Sunday is also Sing Out Day.
And I'm singing.
I'm in a store. And I'm singing. Or you can do the sing out loud, sing out strong. So Common Courtesy Day reminded me. Mm-hmm. I thought maybe there was a chance you were going to line up a guest for today's show, but we've had so much enjoyment over the last couple of days.
She works for the health department, so she was calling to a meeting during the showtime this morning.
So my cousin Jenny,
she said we're welcome to play the video if we wanted to.
Okay, yeah, I don't have it, so I won't. We'll get to it later. But she encountered she had one of those situations where she was able to be a good citizen. Was this a younger person?
No, she thinks she was older than her.
Okay, well, it was a person at the grocery store who ran across a chicken and for purchase, and the concern of the other person in the store was her fear that she didn't know what to do with it because the chicken had bones in it.
Well, so Jenny said they were out of boneless, skinless chicken.
Mm-hmm.
So they only had the split breast, and she went to pick up a couple of packages, and the lady said, "What are you going to do with that?" She said, "Well, I think I'll make some chicken and dumplings." And she said, "No, I mean, it's got a bone in it.
It's got a bone in it.
What are you going to do with that?
Like, do not pass." Do not pass go. Go directly to jail. It has a bone in it.
You can't cook chicken with a bone in it.
Right. And I just thought, so yeah, I guess this is the world.
Yeah.
You know, that.
Well, Jenny really, she called me and then she put out a public service announcement video and she said, "I'm concerned about our survival skills."
Yeah.
"And I think we need to share what we know with each other. We need to start really beginning to educate each other. You can cook chicken with a bone in it and eat it and survive. You don't have to eat the bone."
I guess before yesterday or day before, if you had given this lady a quiz on the anatomy of a chicken, name the parts of a chicken. Nugget.
Right. Strip. Fingers.
Strip.
Fingers.
Right.
Hot wing.
You've got to get creative. You know. Misty, in your office, you have long ago come up with a creative solution to avoid neck strain. You built a fancy wrapped box that your computer monitor sits on.
Yes.
So that it is at eye level rather than you having to look down.
Yes.
Well, now that we're all having to create home offices.
I'm here. I'm for hire for help.
So I have
freelancing
over the several last months. I have, because of my leadership role at the KBA, I have had to participate in more virtual meetings, which involve working from my desk. And you all know what my shelves look like, right?
It's a museum of
pop culture. And then my Saracels, my Warner Brothers Saracels. So it does not fail. I get a question during almost every meeting. What's in that one cubby that's above the, right? So I'm telling you, these working from home meetings that you're having, be aware of what's in the background behind you.
I've been saying this for a long time.
We learned this with the selfie of the really sexy lady with the unflushed toilet behind her.
Right? Mm-hmm. I mean, good grief.
You just lost your sexy.
Right.
You may want to try to find that and get that back.
With things like strewn around in their living room and on their dining room table.
When your parents educate you, be aware of your surroundings. We're going to take that to a new place.
It just means safety-wise. But there are people now sharing novel ways that they are converting their homes into workspaces. And I don't know how Sam will get to these, but there's the laptop on top of the rolling garbage can.
Okay, all right.
Because if you're used to standing at work, have a standing desk, you need something at that height.
Yep.
You can take that outside and do that.
There you go.
You can back against an entryway door. You can have a little office chair and a little end table there. And then you could sit on the back of your car. And then the spoiler. Have you seen that one?
The young lady sitting
on the car where she's sitting on her car. I think it's a Lexus with a big racing spoiler.
Yep.
And the spoiler is her desk top.
I think it's fantastic. She's the perfect size for
that. So we're all having to get creative about how we go about.
Yeah.
Now, if the pandemic wasn't bad enough.
Are they just showing off their water in that picture? Show-offs with your water supply.
Yes, yeah, they're just showing off. They use a case of water and put their laptop on.
You're so fancy, we get
the,
it.
On the case of water. Not all of us can have a Christmas paper-wrapped box to put our monitor on. But
if mine goes missing, I'm coming to your office.
I don't have that problem, and you know why.
Well, I didn't get a theater screen.
There's no strain. There's no strain on my part.
No, you don't look down. You just look back and forth like a tennis match trying to figure out.
Yeah, I have to plot coordinates to get from one side of mine to the other.
I'm going to roll over here and read the rest of the sentence.
Well, it was either buy a huge monitor or get glasses. I opted to.
The monitor was so much cheaper.
It probably was.
No.
Yeah.
You bought glasses recently?
So the pandemic is leading people to make dangerous decisions in self-care because I bring to you the bangdemic.
We talked about this. We predicted this.
Americans are experimenting with home workouts, intricate recipes, and new hairstyles. One popular trend has emerged on social media, cutting your bangs out of boredom.
Just don't get bored. Wrong. Sweetheart.
Be careful with trigger-happy trimmers. It's hard to walk back.
Was she using the electronic turkey cutter?
I know your hairdresser may make it look easy.
But it's not.
Yeah.
Don't do it.
It's kind of like...
They went to school for a long time.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so just be careful about...
Don't do it. The first thing I said, my first concern is you're all going to cut your own hair and send your kids back to school ugly.
I do like some of the novel approaches that moms have been taking to... because now they're both mom and school teacher and... There's the one mom who is making her children, or at least for a couple of days, at last report, by day five, she may be like, "What? Do whatever you want to do. I don't care." But the mom who is making her children get up and get dressed for school.
Okay.
They were even going as far as pretending to ride the bus before they would find their workspace. They would
How does that work?
She would set chairs up in the living room. They would get on the bus and walk down and sit down in their bus seat, and then they would sing Wheels on the Bus.
I was going to say Wheels on the Bus.
And then they would get off the bus and then go to their classrooms and start working. Right?
Simulation is good.
And I'd say that's an awesome idea for three or four days.
Time.
And then on Friday, mom says, spring break.
Over.
I do appreciate all the moms that says, we brought spanking back in school.
Yeah.
Spanking is back in prayers.
It's been added right back.
Yes.
Everybody
pray prays every morning again.
I'm going to pray for you babies before
one
I spank you.
Mom has shared her tricks for keeping her kids from eating snacks all day long.
I love this trick.
She has a color-coded basket for each of them, and she fills their basket up at the beginning of every day with the snacks and a cup so that she's not washing 50 cups a day. And the child knows when their basket is empty, there are no more snacks.
Yep.
So this way, they have to choose, do I really want a snack, knowing that I'm going to be out?
Really rationing.
That's just one of, I'd say, many, many ideas that people are having to...
Did you hear the prayer, the lady I posted?
I did not, because, again, internet, awful at home.
I just want to encourage everyone, go find the prayer of the lady praying. Learn this prayer and pray it over your children. But a couple of things I want to highlight that you want to pray is... she has asked for the angel of the carryover to come down and teach them how to carry the one, and there would be an answer.
The angel of the carryover.
Yeah. The Common Core has caused confusion in their house. The only thing they have in common is frustration. Yeah. And the devil has sent her child a tapeworm, and she doesn't quit eating. So she's going to need a cure for that.
I love it. That's great.
It's nice.
it's the best prayer, and I would say we're all going to be praying it. And she ends it with, Lord, you know I'm your child, but I'm also going to be an inmate. Send some help.
Drastic times.
And don't
times.
Look good in orange or jumpsuits, Father.
Drastic times, drastic measures.
Send the help, Lord.
So online dating has been going on for a while, right? Uh-huh. But it's been more of the text variety. And now we're finding people who are having to get more creative. They're spending more time actually having like Google Hangouts dates or FaceTime or whatever it is that this is the because they can't go out or they can't travel on public transportation to get to the other or whatever it might be. So there are many things I'm just wondering if we're going to are that things will innovation. Necessity is the mother of all invention. Mm-hmm. What things will we choose to do during this time of disruption that become common practice as a result
sure.
of it? You know, we'll drive in movies and drive in church. Will it become a thing that goes, yeah, we're going to do that.
I like it.
And perhaps some of the best news that I've received in the last week, the Cheesecake Factory is offering free slices during a time of uncertainty.
Oh, praise be to the baby Jesus.
I'm feeling very uncertain right now.
I am too.
Matter of fact,
two slices would help me feel more certain in the future.
Some certainty, yeah. A whole cheesecake.
Yeah, I need the whole thing.
Might solidify my certainty for about 3 days. And then if conditions arise again, then I'll reach out and let you know.
Yeah.
I think that would be excellent.
Yeah.
You use the free slice promo code.
You
get a free slice of cheesecake from the Cheesecake Factory. We got to get to a break. Come back. Got some entertainment news. Later on the show today, chart toppers, point to ponder, pearl of wisdom, and more. Hang around here on In the Know.
Brian, proud to be right here tour. Friday, October 23rd, Rupp Arena.
Yeah, that's my kind of night.
Luke Bryan live.
Live. Play it again.
With special guests, Morgan Wallen. And Runaway June. Get access to preferred seating with your city card. Tickets are on sale now. Get tickets at LiveNation.com or the Central Bank Center ticket office. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com.
Does your nonprofit engage volunteers to fulfill your social mission? Is there a need to better engage volunteers to meet critical community needs? If so, learn how to improve volunteer engagement across your organization through participating in the Service Enterprise Initiative. The Service Enterprise Certificate Program includes a comprehensive organizational assessment, training series, and professional coaching. Expand the impact of your organization through volunteers. Visit serve.ky.gov.
Moms will do anything to keep their kids safe. That's why every time we get in the car, even if it's just to the corner groceries, we play the seatbelt game. Whoever fastens their seatbelt first wins. Usually it's Sarah. I call her the fastest click in Kentucky. Her big brother may get his pride bruised, but at least I know we're all safe. Be safe, Kentucky. Buckle up and put the phone down.
Hey, Kentucky, your voice counts. Taking the census helps Kentucky receive funds for school lunches, life-saving medical care, educational programs, roads and bridges, and other programs that benefit you, your family, and your community. The census is just 9 questions and only takes 10 minutes to complete. Plus, it's safe and secure. By April 1st, your home will receive official Census Bureau mail with info on how to respond. So, Kentucky, let your voice be heard. Be counted. Learn more at countmeinky2020.com.
On the basketball court, you have to know where the lines are. It's just as important to know where the lines are in your own yard. Kentucky law generally requires you to have underground utility lines located before most excavation work, even if it's on your own property. If you don't call 811 and you damage a natural gas line, the Kentucky Public Service Commission will investigate you and you may be fined up to $1,250. Much better to stay within the bounds of the law and call before you dig to start putting in that backboard or goalpost. For more information, visit psc.ky.gov. This message brought to you by the Kentucky Public Service Commission.
The federal government provides $150 billion a year to make higher education possible for anyone. Completing the free application for federal student aid, known as the FAFSA, is the first step to getting your share. But an estimated $40 million in financial aid is left on the table each year by Kentucky students. Don't let that happen to you.
Fill out the new and improved FAFSA today. Visit knowhowtogoky.org and join the conversation on Twitter, #knowhowtopayky. This message is brought to you by the Pritchard Committee Student Voice Team and the Council on Post-Secondary Education.
Before I stepped foot on campus, I thought I had to fit in, conform.
be like everyone else. But then I found a powerful community, inspiring me to be me, seeking opportunities I never knew existed, like working with Apple to develop an app to help future students succeed. I'm Asari Nkansa, and my journey at the University of Kentucky is making my dream of helping others wildly possible. Find your possible at uky.edu.
K105 Weather is brought to you by Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
Twin Lakes Weather. We'll see some sunshine for the late morning before we see some scattered showers and thunderstorms as we head into the afternoon with that cold front moving through. Your temperatures going from the 70s later this morning down into the 50s for this evening. We'll be dealing with breezy conditions throughout the entire day. From the Wave 3 News Storm Tracking Team, I'm meteorologist Tawana Andrew.
ABC, easy as 1, 2, 3. I'll say, but let's go, break me. ABC, 1, 2, 3, baby, you and me, girl. Easy as 1, 2, 3. I'll say, but let's go, break me. ABC, 1, 2, 3, baby, you and me, girl.
Did you know? Remember when we were kids, grown-ups would tell us when we make funny faces, they'd say, don't do that with your face, it'll stick.
Yep.
Well, there's a reason they told us that.
Mm-hmm.
In the 19th century, experts warned about a disease called bicycle face, which meant getting stuck with the awkward faces you make when riding a bicycle.
Is it just limited to bicycles?
That's what this is. It's called a bicycle face.
Mine's more of a suck air face, like, I can't breathe.
It would be completely dependent upon the conditions of my riding. You know, going downhill, I wouldn't mind being stuck with that face.
Yeah.
Oh, but going uphill.
But the one coming uphill, I'd be like, oh gosh, not going to be able to do it. Yeah, bicycle face.
That's kind of funny. Yeah.
Is that like Butterface?
Yes, but, yeah, I'm a Butterface.
Butterface.
Everything's cute about a Butterface.
You got it.
At least something that was cute about me.
So you were onto something, Misty, the other day. Netflix was asked to slow down streaming so the internet doesn't break.
Listen, it's like I'm prophetic. I'm telling you, Bad Bangs and Netflix is going to be... I knew it.
Netflix currently uses adaptive streaming, which automatically adjusts picture quality based on a network's capacity. So... you'll see, you know, more and more. By the way, would you? Before I talk about Netflix, what's coming in April? Hallmark will be having a Christmas movie marathon for viewers stuck at home this weekend. Which in portions of the country they are.
If you put your Christmas lights back up, joy to the world.
Yep. I guess it actually starts at noon today, 11 o'clock Central Time.
Well, I'll be leaving at 11:55.
Christmas detour, holiday date, a Christmas love story, Mingle All the Way.
Oh.
Well, if that doesn't sound like a wonderful Christmas movie, I don't know what does.
I like that one.
Christmas Under Wraps and Crown for Christmas.
Yeah, no thanks. Crown Royal or King Crown or crayons.
Netflix will... There's very little leaving Netflix in April. I think they realize, like, more content, the better. Because binging can only last for so long. But coming to Netflix April 1, a whole slew of stuff, but a couple of things I marked that you might be interested in knowing. 40 Days and 40 Nights. It somehow feels apocalyptic.
Right? Like, of toilet paper.
Cheech and Chong's Up in Smoke.
I hear you knocking, but you can't come
in. All four Lethal Weapon movies are coming to Netflix April 1st. The Hangover will be coming April 1st, which we watched last weekend, by the way. We watched the version on TBS, and it is just not the same.
When they clean it up, it's also not the same in the group.
It is the same as it's the same as Breakfast Club and the same as Smokey and the Bandit. If you're going to watch it on TV, edited for TV, don't even bother.
All right.
It changes the comedic timing. Yeah. It changes every... I'm not just looking... it's not the profanity.
Yeah.
It's just... It changed... The overdubbing is a... You know, it's like he's going along. It's just... Don't ruin it.
We're more of the Dirty Birds.
No, I just... I don't...
I'm not. I've never watched
the... All the Matrix movies, all three Matrix movies will be coming out. The Good, Bad, and the Ugly will be coming out on April 2nd.
That sounds fitting right now.
April 16th, Despicable Me.
It was the worst
coming
of times.
To the
it was the best of times.
Despicable Me. That's good.
It was Days Without Toilet Paper. Oh, I love Despicable Me.
Yep.
What is it that...
Minions, right? Minions.
No, what's the... She's holding the stuffed animal. What is it she says that we used to love?
It's so fluffy, I'm going to die!
Yes, I love that. Remember that part? I'll find it for you in the break.
Have you seen what Ellen's been doing while she's been quarantined?
I hope not cutting her bangs.
Her show is just basically calling all her celebrity friends and having FaceTime interviews.
Oh.
And then Jimmy Fallon has joked that he and his wife have realized they actually like each other during self-isolation.
She seems
it's
nice.
It's kind of joking. It's like, yeah, okay. I kind of forgot who you were.
There's a lady in my house.
And in a sign of perhaps things to come, we know how China is going to fix their economy. You know, China's kind of on the other side of maybe where we are, where we're hoping to get to. Harry Potter to the rescue at movie theaters everywhere in China. A 3D 4K restoration of Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone will hit Chinese cinemas in an attempt to win back audiences after weeks of coronavirus closures.
Now, I think it would. Well, here's the thing. Like, I would be interested in going to the theater to see, like, the original Jaws or, you know, like some of those classics that we've not seen in theater in decades. That may work.
Gonna have to get really creative. It's gonna be an all hands on deck type solution to try and figure this thing out.
Yeah.
Gotta get to a break. We'll come back. We've got the point to ponder, chart toppers, and pearl of wisdom, plus what might be on your television this weekend. That's ahead here on In the Know.
You won't believe what I did the other day. I rented a jackhammer and used it to chip away the concrete foundation of my home. It was a lot of work, but I was determined to finish the job. And when I did, about a third of my home was perched atop a large gaping hole. I didn't chisel away the foundation as part of the home improvement project. I wasn't making way for a new addition. I just decided that particular corner of the foundation wasn't very important. Sure, there was living space above the hole, but so what? The rest of the foundation is still there. I'm sure everything's going to be fine. Okay, so I didn't really take a jackhammer to my house like that. And if anybody did, you and I would agree that person's crazy. We both understand that the foundation of a structure is the most crucial part. It supports everything above it, including the people inside. The same is true for our society. Our nation is built on a foundation of values. Values about family, values about truth, values about human worth and human dignity. They're crucial to our culture's well-being and survival. Only a fool would destroy a third of what he depends on for his or her survival. Change is constant in culture, and I'm all for it when it's harnessed for our ultimate good and stability. But when we thoughtlessly redefine life, faith, marriage, and family, we're taking a jackhammer to the foundation of our country we depend on for survival. Let's be mindful of that. For Focus on the Family, I'm Jim Daly.
Get lured in by a tender Filet-O-Fish from McDonald's. Enjoy two of them now for just $5. Made with flaky Alaskan pollock from sustainable fisheries, it's a crispy, steamy, tangy treat that'll leave you ready to dive in for another bite. Plus, add any size soft drink like an ice-cold Sprite for just $1. Catch this deal before it's gone. Only at McDonald's. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with combo meal. Single item at regular price.
I was in the hospital with my son for 18 months.
When he got injured, I knew I had to be strong.
I just remember rushing into his room and giving him a big hug and letting him know I was there.
These veterans and families are just a few of the heroes we serve at Homes for Our Troops. We build specially adapted custom homes with features like wheelchair access and automatic door openers that allow them to focus on their recovery and family.
This house is freedom.
It's hope. It's a new beginning.
Visit HFOTUSA.org.
I'm Andrew Saul, Commissioner of Social Security. Beware of telephone scammers pretending to be government employees. Real Social Security employees will never threaten you. Callers threatening you with arrest or other legal action and demanding money are not from us. If you receive a call like this, hang up, do not provide them with any form of payment or information, report the call at oig.ssa.gov. census.gov.
Hey, Kentucky, your voice counts. Taking the census helps Kentucky receive funds for school lunches, life-saving medical care, educational programs, roads and bridges, and other programs that benefit you, your family, and your community. The census is just 9 questions and only takes 10 minutes to complete. Plus, it's safe and secure. By April 1st, your home will receive official Census Bureau mail with info on how to respond. So, Kentucky, let your voice be heard. Be counted. Learn more at countmeinky2020.com.
When you see a red or yellow traffic light, you know it means to stop. If you see a red or yellow flag in the ground, it means go. The flags mark underground utility lines, giving you the green light to start digging. Red is electric, and yellow is a gas line. For the green light to start any digging project, call 811 or go to 811now.com. All utility lines must be marked before you start digging. Contact 811 2 days before you start and watch for the red and yellow flags before you begin digging. It's a free service, and it's the law. And you're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as
sweet as strawberry wine. The MB's point of ponder for today. You're as wild. So today's the first full day of spring. We got a bonus hour and 11 minutes last night.
Wow.
First day of spring. So does that make my, now, should I consider my winter fat spring rolls? Like, we've officially gone from winter fat to spring rolls.
I just told you all I've been intermittent fasting. Yeah. I'm down, you know, 6 pounds. And literally the only thing that feels smaller are my earlobes. Like, look at my earlobes today. See how small they are?
My lobes look really fit. Yeah. Yeah, you'll... Yeah.
Like, my fingertips are skinny.
Well, I mean, it's got to all come off from somewhere.
Yeah, my glasses felt better this morning.
My leopard day.
That's all I got.
I gained in my cheeks.
Yeah. On TV tonight, The Blacklist. The return of season 7. One of the videos I saw yesterday was funny. You mentioned yesterday, Misty, about who was the artist that was out on their balcony playing? Was it playing the piano? And then somebody, just a guy.
I don't know who the artist was. It was somebody in Spain.
And then a neighbor across the way picked up on the saxophone and was playing. So Trevor Noah went out yesterday and was singing A Whole New World because, you know, his heritage, and he was singing A Whole New World. So he starts out there, and you can hear one of his neighbors in the background go, "Shut up!"
That would so be me.
It's like,
shut it down. a Nerf gun, you.
You know, you were just kind of expecting something, you know, good to happen or whatever. It's like, shut up. Tomorrow on TV. Oh, by the way, you talked about it earlier when we were talking about the UK Classic Series. Tomorrow, I think at 3:00 Central Time, the March 1992 UK versus Duke game. So I also know how that one turns out. If
Me
you know
too.
it's been nearly 30 years. If you're up to it,
we
do
win
it.
That one, right?
You know how it hits Leitner.
That's what I thought you said. All the games we were playing.
No. This is on CBS.
Oh,
all the games we're playing. All the games we're airing are winners.
Yeah. Why would they re-air that?
It's one of the greatest games in college basketball history. I mean,
know
it's
exactly
still
where I was.
It is still.
Yeah, but it's,
it is still in the opening credits to every NCAA tournament game.
But it's so contentious, and we're already in a fight over toilet paper.
That's right.
Why would you do that?
Well, just because they know people are going to tune in.
I have not been afraid till now.
But UK fans is kind of like, well, I don't know if I'm ready.
No,
you know, it was
just
a couple of years ago. The shirts were still. I still hate Christian Leitner. I don't.
Yeah.
I think actually it would be fun. It's not going to hurt any worse. It's hurt for 30 years. I think it actually would kind of be enjoyable to go back and watch the whole thing.
You think so?
Again, you know how it's going to turn out.
I think you've gone mad in a post-apocalyptic world we're in.
I guess that's certainly possible. Tomorrow night, though.
Just don't cut your own hair.
Saturday Night Live, they're replaying the episode where J.J. Watt was the host and musical guest was Luke Combs, and it was one of the worst. I like J.J. Watt just fine, but... Saturday Night Live was too big for J.J. Watt. It was not one of the better episodes. And then Hollywood Week on American Idol continues on Sunday night. This will be the duets round. So you'll see them pair off. And with social distancing,
Barbie and Ken are going to sing.
I presume. You know, it does make you wonder. I wonder if they're in the same group.
They'd have to be. You got to keep them together. You love them together.
I don't care for her.
Really? You don't care for her?
Not much. What?
Really? No. Interesting.
I mean, are you a real girl?
Yeah, that's what Luke said, right? Are you real? Today's highlight in history, this date in 1854, the Republican Party of the United States was founded by slavery opponents at a schoolhouse in Ripon, Wisconsin. In 1413, England's King Henry IV died. He was succeeded by King Henry...
Slips my mind. Hold on.
I think it was the fifth. I'm going to go out on a limb and say King Henry V succeeded King Henry IV.
No, I think Henry VIII killed 5, 6, and 7.
I am. Second verse. Simon's the first. 1996, a jury in Los Angeles convicted Eric and Lyle Menendez of first-degree murder. Birthdays today. Carl Reiner is 98. Hal Linden is 89. Hal Linden played Barney Miller on TV. Mm. Brian Mulroney, former Canadian Prime Minister, is 81. Pat Riley is 75. Spike Lee is 63. Holly Hunter is 62 today. So my favorite Holly Hunter role is the mom in The Incredibles, of course.
Oh, I forgot about her being the mom. I like her in Twister.
Kathy Ireland is 57. That was Helen Hunt.
Who am I thinking?
Holly Hunter. She's more red-haired, fair-skinned, kind of.
I have to Google her.
Mikey Day from Saturday Night Live is 40 today. Ozzie Nelson was born this date in 1906. Mr. Rogers, Fred Rogers, that is, born in 1928. Jerry Reed was born this date in 1937. Snowman, gone but not forgotten. Mm. I like Jerry Reed.
I do too.
Eastbound and Down. Let's go to Chart Toppers. 1955 was the year. Webb Pierce, number one.
He's in the jailhouse now.
Dad, I love this song.
Well, I had a friend named Ramble and Bob who used to steal.
I think this would be a good weekend for old brother.
It would be, wouldn't
this
it?
This would be a really good weekend for old brother.
Yeah, you should go out in your neighborhood and sing that and see what they think. Let us know your neighbors respond.
Shut up!
Yeah, there is a chance.
Yeah. So you're saying there's a chance.
I'm the paterfamilias. It's a geographical oddity. 3 days from everywhere.
It's a good movie.
Well, I was a lion.
I was a lion. Forgiven of all those sins.
Piggly Wiggly and Yazoo.
I think you'll understand.
So many good one-liners.
Yeah.
She R-U-N-N-O-F-T. I mean.
It's been so long since I've seen it.
Mrs. Hogwallop. And then she R-U-N-N-O-F-T. I mean, it just doesn't.
I mean, Hogwallop alone.
Do not seek the treasure.
People all over the world.
A horny toad. It goes, I mean, John Goodman's in it.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Goodness gracious, it's so good.
Yeah. Sounds like a plan for the weekend.
And stay out of the Woolworths. I'm telling you, it goes.
So
I mean, they go on and on. Yeah.
Been baptized.
We need to get us some of that reform, Pappy. We're the incumbent, you idiot. Here we are in here talking into our singing cans, right? Microphone. Journey, Open Arms. 1982.
The candle I saw.
That's the truth.
Yeah, I'm not. My arms are not open. Yeah,
closed
any of you
arms.
All?
Closed arms. Yeah.
So here we are behind closed doors.
Closed fist as well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let's go to 1991. Mariah Carey, number one in 91 with Someday. How you feel about Third Eye Blind?
I like. It depends on.
Yeah, it depends on the song.
Yeah.
The year would have been 2000.
What's the song?
And the song would
Semi-charmed?
Be. Would be Semi-Charmed Life is right. Is that Third Eye Blind?
Mm, yeah. This I'm thinking Blind Melon.
This is. Oh yeah. This is Never Gonna Let You Go. Never Let You Go.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah,
oh okay. Well, I should have picked Toby Keith. How Do You Like Me Now? Then.
Oh, yeah, it's just like a song that doesn't speak to me.
They were doing the best they could.
Well, that's most of us are. Doesn't mean they want to put us on radio.
Let's go to the year 2009.
Oh.
Flo Rida.
You spin my head right round when you go down, when you go down, down.
Got the house with my swagger, hop in that whip, yo, I got places to go. People to see, time is precious, I look at
right round, baby, right round.
Big fan.
Like a record, baby. Right round, round, round. Mm. And let's go 2 years ago today. Bruno Mars with Cardi B. This is Finesse. I can catch. Not a bad outfielder in my day. MB's Pearl of Wisdom for today. Ralph Waldo Emerson. I think it's perfect for a day like today. Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "Common sense is genius dressed in its working clothes." Common sense is genius dressed in its working clothes. MB's Pearl of Wisdom for today. Look forward to seeing you back here on Monday for another edition of our show. For Misty Thomas, for Beege, I'm MB, and now you're in the know.
Powered by Heritage Media of Kentucky, WKHG Litchfield, Kentucky, USA, 104.9 FM, the Twin Lakes, Best Mix, K105, your news star.